After Golden Globes used to launch Oprah's 2020 presidential run, she gets nasty surprise. Move over Michelle Obama, Oprah Winfrey have been declared the Democratic candidate to take on President Donald Trump in 2020. Winfrey accepted a Lifetime Achievement Award at the Golden Globes, delivering a speech filled with creepy leftist rhetoric like a slick politician, and immediately afterward, NBC and other major outlets named her the 46th President of the United States. However, it went all wrong as she got a nasty surprise she never saw coming. The only Americans who watched the Golden Globe Awards last night were the useful idiots who tune in to see their beloved Hollywood role models pat each other on the back and self-congratulate each other as masters of the universe. So, when the internet erupted with headlines reporting, "Oprah for President 2020, we thought it was a big joke. Boy, we wrong. It seems Oprah Winfrey is running for president in 2020. In a totally planned move, Winfrey delivered a campaign speech written by seasoned politicos at the Golden Globe Awards last night. It was filled with the same tired leftist rhetoric slanted toward feminists, but that was just act one. The whole show was a coordinated effort to launch Winfrey as the Democratic frontrunner. Host Seth Meyers set the tone for Oprah's candidacy in his opening monologue. "I told some jokes about our current president at the White House correspondents' dinner, jokes about how he was unqualified to be president, and some have said that night convinced him to run," said Meyers, referring to his scalding roast of Donald Trump in 2011, according to CNN. "So, if that's true, I just want to say, Oprah, you will never be president. You do not have what it takes." See how everything was geared toward Oprah's big moment? Then, NBC and other media outlets started posting endorsements for Oprah 2020. CNN is even admitting Oprah knew exactly what she was doing on Sunday night. The former talk show host, who is touted as an American icon by the leftists, started the Barack Obama-like speech by recalling her poverty-stricken childhood, sitting on linoleum floors. Then, it morphed into a diatribe on racism in America, and she closed with the sexual harassment movement, started by Harvey Weinstein's alleged crimes. "I want to say that I value the press more than ever before as we try to navigate these complicated times, which brings me to this: what I know for sure is that speaking your truth is the most powerful tool we all have. For too long, women have not been heard or believed if they dared to speak their truth to the power of those men, but their time is up," said Winfrey. It seemed completely phony, and when she started talking about women needing to tell their truth, you know that's the evil commie buzz phrase. There is only one truth, there is the only truth, which is Jesus Christ, and in life, there are not different versions of the truth. That part of her speech especially creeped me out. Well, Oprah might want to rethink her platform. Americans who live in the flyover states aren't impressed with the Hollywood crowd pushing their queen on us as our next president. She might want to rethink her whole fake outrage at sexual abuse happening in Hollywood too, and that's where she got blasted with a nasty surprise. Twitter user David Thompson posted, "Apparently both Oprah and Meryl Streep lectured the Golden Globes audience last night on sexual harassment. Wow. Two women who not just knew about Harvey Weinstein but hated and abetted his appetite for sexual perversion think they are righteous. Such hypocrisy is stunning." Then, there are the allegations by actresses who say Oprah played pimp for Harvey Weinstein. Aspiring actress, Katie Ann Noble, says Harvey Weinstein used Oprah Winfrey and Naomi Campbell to dupe her into thinking he would help her with her career, only to use her for sex, reported Page Six. "Oprah has been and is a fraud. The whole establishment is a joke. The libs in Hollywood live in a world of fairy tales, where a rapist can rise to power. Look at who they have supported, and defended, over recent years: Roman Polanski, Bill Clinton, and Harvey Weinstein," posted Goldie44 on Twitter. Of course, Oprah knew about Harvey Weinstein. This phony baloney speech that she made sounded exactly like Barack Obama. Same cadence, same talking points, same bullcrap. Oprah as commander-in-chief? What is she going to do if our country is threatened? Bomb the hell out of our enemies with sugary Hallmark Hall of Fame videos so we can all get along? "Oprah for President is a joke," and they are banking on all women and all African Americans voting for Winfrey. That's their strategy, more identity politics. Americans want strong borders, security, support for our police and military, and jobs. That doesn't change based on our skin color or genitalia. Oprah needs to stick to giving tips on weight gain and eating fresh veggies, or whatever the heck she's into these days. Leave leading the most powerful country in the world to President Donald Trump, who has proven in just 1 year that he is keeping his promises and making America great again.